Hey, I managed already multiple times to print watertight stuff on 3D printer, and you can see in my previous episodes explaining how to do that. So I thought, let's think about airtight prints. Welcome to the Taboretum channel, I'm Tomek and I will tell you today about my journey in airtight prints. Here is the thing that I have finally designed and printed and tested. And as you can see, we have a valve here. It's a valve like you can have in your tire and a container with a lid that I have designed and 3D printed. So let's jump to the FreeCAD and I will show you how I designed it. And then we'll do some testing and it will be fun. Expect some booms. Here we have my first approach. You can see a container. Maybe let's turn off some of the things. So here's the container. As you can see, it is a revolution of a simple sketch that you can see here. We revolve it. Then we add some threads. We finish the threads so they look nice and sexy. And there is an episode about that that you can find somewhere in the description. And that's the basic shape. And my idea was to have the O-ring, so the sealant, in the cap. So here's the cap sitting on top. I made it transparent so you can see a bit better. And I will turn off the container for a minute. So there is a cap with the threads. Yeah, we don't need that. And here is the O-ring. I made it blue so you can easily see. And the idea was that when you screw in our container, it will seal here. And actually, it was not working great. I was wondering why I decided to change the design, and when preparing for this particular video, actually I figured out what was wrong. You can see there's a crosscut of this object, and what is now obvious, if you have this crosscut, is that I actually designed it incorrectly. You can see that this arc here is not matching the O-ring. So probably this was why this design was not working properly. Plus, it all depends on how strong this thread is and how strong you can screw the thing in. So I thought, let's go away from the jar-like approach to something that I'm more familiar with. So underwater torches, where the O-ring is actually on the side. So this is my second design where let's turn off the lid. Where is that? Let's turn off the cap for a second. Yeah. So this is basically the same shape with similar threads, but there is a groove here for the O-ring. And when you put the cap on, you can see here that the cap will squeeze the O-ring to the container, and here we can see the threads. So this is what I actually printed out and tested. And basically what was happening was that the seal was not perfect, and the part of the problem was the O-ring itself, part of the problem was the print itself, and the damn thing was leaking on the seam of the print. Basically, if you print layers, there is a point where you switch from layer to layer, and there are many parameters that you can set in your slicer. I was trying a lot of them, but actually never managed to get it fully airtight. However, it was airtight enough to hold some pressure. You can see in these short clips, you can see here the bubbles, and these bubbles are coming always exactly from the places where the seam was. And I was trying a variety of settings with the scarf seam, with the random position of a seam, and so on and so forth. And I managed to get to the place where this thing here, can hold some pressure. And some was like 2 bars, 5 bars. I was doing an experiment at home in this very room, and actually one of these containers exploded. And my wife came asking what happened, what just exploded. And I was a bit, I had trouble hearing her speaking to me. But I knew then that it can hold enough. And actually it exploded around 7 bars, which is like, what, 50 PSI, maybe more. So it exploded at 7 bars. And I thought, well, let's do an experiment. Let's try to do it in a safe environment and let's record it. So here you can see my setup to do this experiment. And I thought that I will pour in some sugar powder inside, so when it explodes, we can see some cloud. And I set my camera, my phone camera, to 240 frames per second, hoping that it will be enough to record the explosion. I was disappointed because the thing held, you know what, 12 bars, so over 150 psi. And this was I tested the limit of my bike pump, because my bike pump, it's a road bike, so the bike pump can do like 12 bars, but that's it. So actually, it didn't explode, it was not airtight, but I thought, well, I have few of these because I was trying these all crazy settings, so let's try many of them.
So, let's try this one. Without too much talking, let's just pump. 4, 6, 8, 10. And this time it broke.
So initially it holded the 12 bars for a fraction of a second and it went down. And then when I pressed the pump again, it did explode. And you can see here that the 240 frames per second are not enough. You can barely see the explosion, but you can see the results. Here are the tiny pieces. And nobody got hurt, no animals, no humans, not myself. And this proves that you can hold some pressure in a 3D print. I will still experiment because I was using PETG and PLA. I have some ASA at home, ASA filament. It is said to have a very good layer adhesion, so we will see if it's better or not. There's also this parameter perimeter gap that you can go negative. So basically this end of the parameters is overlapping and I haven't pushed these to the limit. So maybe this is an option. But if I will really make it airtight, be sure that I will shoot a video on that. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to press the like button, subscribe, and consider buying me a coffee. There's a link down there. Your feedback is really motivating me for further work. Thanks. Cheers. Bye-bye.